One thing I can't complain about is the abundance of kale I've gotten from the garden. It doesn't seem to mind the poor soil this year, and it's just gone crazy. So I've been dehydrating it. I've got a tray in there, and I'm putting it on here. I have to check for the little cabbage worms, the occasional cabbage worm like this one. Really don't want to dry him. But so I put it face down. I take every other tray out of my dehydrator, and I put it face down so it lays flatter, and that way I can kind of check for the worms too as I put them on the tray. And in about 24 hours, I've got nice, crunchy fall leaves that they remind me of, and then I'll show you what I do with them at that point. Okay, the kale is all done. It takes about 8-9 hours. And if you, I've noticed, this is the only thing I've noticed does this in my dehydrator. The leaves that are towards the front of the dehydrator will stay nice and green, but the ones towards the back will get just a little brown. It doesn't really affect them as far as taste, because I've tasted them. They just don't look as nice as these nice big green ones. So, you know, just keep an eye on it. You might want to rotate the trays halfway through if you're around to do that. But I'd say no more than 8-9 hours. On the kale. And this is what I do with it. I just use a plain old plastic bag, and I put my leaves in there, and they're just like fall leaves. And they're just that crispy. And I put them in the bag. And I've done this several times, as you can see in the bottom of my bag is some previous batches. My bag is looking a little worn and tired. That's okay. I'm just going to put a few in here and I'll show you what I do. And there's lots of different ways. You could store it like this if you wanted, like a whole leaf. You could do that. But what I want is a powder. So I'm going to seal this up all but one little corner so I don't pop my bag. This is so much easier to do two-hand. I'm going to leave a little corner of it open, and then I'm just going to muff it, like kneading bread. And what I find after I do this a little bit, and shake it, and do it, and shake it, is you can pull out the stems. The leaves will be crushed, and you'll just have those stems left, and you can pull them right out of there. Okay? And get all the green leafy material off. Actually, if you're going to grind these up further, and I'll show you that, you probably don't need to take those stems out, but I just think it gives you a nicer product, so to speak. Okay, so now I'm going to open this back. Come back here. Now open this back up. Give it a couple shakes, and if you do that, you see the stems come to the top. Real easy to take out, and all the leaves fall to the bottom, so you can just take those old stems out and like that. See, like this one. I usually crunch them up a little bit more. You can use your hand too as you pick them up. Take them out, get rid of all the little sticks, and just keep shaking the bag, and they'll come to the top. There's another one. And then you just have the leaves left. Now, from this point, if you want, you can put them into a little coffee grinder, electric coffee grinder, and you can grind it up into a very fine powder, which is what I'm going to do with at least some of it. So you can sneak that into all kinds of things. See? Maybe even make a cream of kale soup out of it. But a lot of people just leave it this state where it looks like parsley. And I love Mrs. Bev from the Mrs. Volfie Channel, where she sprinkles it on mashed potatoes and her husband thinks it's parsley. I love that. But there, that's what I'm going to do with all my kale. So, and it takes an enormous amount to fill up even this much. This is probably, well, I only use every other tray because it's so bulky. But this is probably 4 batches now once I get these other ones in here. So I don't even have a full bag yet, but, you know, if you just sneak it in here and there, that's going to last you a long time. Okay, to make some kale chips, I've just got some kale leaves that I have stripped off of that center vine. You know, when you get your kale leaf here, I got so much going on in my kitchen today. But you take that center vein or that center stem right out, and I just use scissors and I cut along each side of it. And you get these leaves, not that one, that was a little one, but you get these leaves without that center vein. And then you're going to put them on your tray. And I've just brushed my tray with a little bit of olive oil. These are so simple. I've never done them before, but I've made a couple batches now and they disappear as soon as I take them out of the oven. In fact, you're probably going to hear my daughter crunching in the background. my oldest, I have to beat her away from them. Yeah. Thank you, Lena. You didn't really need to do that. Anyway, I'm going to just lay these out, and I'll come back when I get them all arranged on my tray, my cookie sheet. Okay, I've got my kale laid out on my cookie sheet, and this is just some parchment paper that I have under there. And now I'm going to brush it with some olive oil. If you don't want to brush it, then you can use an olive oil spray. But I'm just going to take my little... A brush would work better, but I can't find mine, so I'm using this little spatula. And I'm just going to dab on the olive oil all over as best I can. Don't need to really coat it, but you want some olive oil on that so that the seasonings that you're going to put on will stick and it will crisp up as you're baking it. You're going to put these in the oven. Yeah, that's pretty good. Don't need to go crazy. Alright, and then what we like, and I'm going to experiment with some other kinds, but we like this Jane's crazy mixed up seasonings. Mixed up salt. And, excuse me, I got something in my throat. I'm just going to sprinkle that on rather liberally. You could use just plain old sea salt. You could use some garlic salt and onion powder. You could do it your own mix. And yeah, that's plenty, I think. My youngest complains it's too salty and the oldest doesn't think there's enough. So, and then we're just going to pop these in a 350 degree oven for 10 minutes and we will have kale chips. So we'll be back. Hey, here's our kale chips fresh out of the oven. They are a little limp, but you don't want to overdo these because then they'll get a burnt taste. So you want them green when you take them out. I've learned not brownish green. and they're still kind of like fall leaves. They're very crunchy, and they are wonderful. As a little hand comes in and steals one.
Yummy.
So there you go. Another use for kale. I can